What's up, what's up, what's going on everyone? This is Matt, SqueakyClean Air. Today we are going to be installing or getting ready to install the downpipe on my Mk7 GTI. I went with the CTS tuning downpipe and can't wait to put it in. And hopefully the next step is going to be after this is we're going to be doing an upgraded intercooler install, and for the meantime I'm going to be running an oxygen defogger in order not to get this check engine light, and eventually once that's there we're going to get it tuned, and hopefully I'm going to stay at stage two. Currently it has a colder intake on it, it has a blow-off valve, it has an upgraded turbo inlet pipe, and it has has a cat, and it has no muffler, and resonator has been taken off. So it's just basic mods that pretty much all Mk7 guys do on their car. But pretty excited for the CTS tuning downpipe. So let's check this thing out. Pretty cool little box. Nice. Performance parts. I guess this is in German. Brand spanking new. And let's unbox this thing. Well, not much to it, I guess. There's a downpipe right here. Hunky dory. We all know CTS tuning is good quality stuff. Good bang for the buck. Good quality parts. You can't beat their stuff. I mean, you can get really expensive downpipes and other sort of parts, but these are pretty good. I guess I'm gonna put the oxygen defogger here. I went with the vibrant one. Seems to work the best. Best bang for the buck. I paid about $30 for this. And this puppy is gonna go over here. I used the metal insert. That's what a lot of guys that are running Mk7s are recommending. This is obviously a temporary fix, right? Because I'm going to get it eventually, get it tuned. But I don't want to be driving with a check engine light and stuff. So this will allow me to overcome that. And that's going to go into here. I'm going to go into much more detail on the installation once the car is here. The car is not here right now. Once I bring the car in, I'll be able to install it. And I'll show you guys how I'm going to be putting it underneath the car. And actually doing the installation my way. I mean, let's not kid ourselves. Mk7s, dime a dozen. These installation videos have probably been done by a million people. But, you know, I always do things a little bit different compared to other people. And I have a tendency to sort of a little bit go into details. And any interesting things that I find in regards to this kind of stuff, I usually share with you guys. So there's installation videos. And then there's installation videos that I do that are slightly a little bit different. But I just like to kind of like record most of the stuff I do just to have memories so I can look back on the builds. But nothing insane. I think this is going to be going over the mid-pipe. There's an extension here for that, and two clamps in order to clamp that. And obviously this is going to go on the actual turbo, so we're going to discuss that further. But I like this unboxing. CTS tuning, can't wait to install this thing. I want the Mk7 to be a little bit louder. So stay tuned. Okay, so here's the lovely GTI. First thing that we're gonna do in order to install the downpipe, which is basically over here, we gotta remove this stock one here. Is we have to disconnect the oxygen sensor, which is I kind of took the liberty of of disconnecting. It goes through this little harness here, through here, and it connects to this plug. And so I loosened it up Let me loosen up this one over here as well. There's a little retainer bracket that you kind of just pull out through, just like that. Bang. Because what's going to happen is when we remove the downpipe, we're going to remove the oxygen sensor with it, and then we're going to put it in onto the new one, which is over here. But what we're going to do is we're going to put a bung on the oxygen sensor, and that way I'm not going to get any codes. So let's jack this baby up, start loosening up the bottom portions of the factory downpipe, and let's get cracking. All right, so we're gonna loosen these up. This is the connection for the factory downpipe, which is over here. And then we're also gonna remove this bracket here with the mounts. And I believe there's another mount somewhere up there, which we're gonna loosen up, and that's where the oxygen sensor sort of sits that we just disconnected up top. These bolts over here that we're gonna remove because we're gonna have an extension that will go through, and then the other downpipe is going to get attached to here. So let's crack all these up and remove it, and we'll go from there. So this little bolt over here is a little bit of a pain in the ass. What it is, it's a 6X, okay, one of these guys. So to save you a lot of pain and aggravation, it's this guy right here. It's a number 6, and you need to use a narrow tool because it's not a lot of space over here. So as a tip for you guys, 6 fits in really nicely, as you can see over here. Bada bim, bada boom. And then just loosen it up, and that will allow you to sort of loosen up the retaining clamp on top over here for the downpipe, which is kind of the last thing for me. So it's a 6. It's a 6X. Be careful, because if you strip this guy, trying to get back from here is a pain in the ass. So if there's any tip I can give you guys, is it's a 6X like this, and then use it on a tool like that. That way you'll never strip it, so you have kind of movement in the back. So just a little tip when you guys are doing this.
I would say probably the toughest part of this downpipe installation is reaching these mounting bolts that are over here on the factory downpipe. And I have the DSG model, so I have the automatic transmission in the way, but you literally, there's one here. I don't know if you guys will be able to see it, but there's one there, part of this bracket. And then there's another one right beside it on the opposite side of it. So you gotta kind of have to reach with your hand and kind of feel it with a 13 mil and a deep socket. So not really, not a lot of videos talk about that, but that's what's a bit of a struggle. And I'm not really sure if I can capture it. It's this bracket over there that I'm zooming in. It has a 13 mil bolt that you kind of have to, and then we're zooming it in over there. Yeah, you're going to have to kind of like scooch your hand in there with a deep socket 13 and kind of reach from one side, which is this side. It's a lot easier kind of to get to. And then the other one, you kind of have to do it just by feel. I don't know. I'm not really sure if a lot of videos talk about that. Some cars have, I guess, easier access than others, but it's a pain in the ass. So I found that to be sort of the toughest part of doing this, is getting to that bracket over there, this little sucker right there. There's a 13 from the inside. So I'm gonna try to reach the other one on the opposite direction of it, just right there. Hopefully I'll loosen it up, and by feel, you kind of have to do it. And those are the two retaining bolts that hold the actual downpipe to the block. And then once that's done, obviously my clamp on the top is already loosened, and there's a retainer bracket over here that you kind of have to loosen, which I already kind of loosened, but I'm holding it up by one bolt because I don't want this to fall. And obviously this little connector here to the mid pipe that I removed as well. Unfortunately, my bolt got rounded. It's a 2018. It's not too bad. The bolts are still okay, but this one is rounded. So this this bracket over here that kind of holds it, or supposed to hold it and retain it, kind of started stripping. So unfortunately, I didn't want to drop my whole exhaust, blah blah blah. So I cut it off. But I think what I'm going to do, either I'm going to try to source another clamp, or this seems like it's stainless steel. I can probably weld it. I can probably put a couple of tacks and then put a nice bead, put two tacks from the back and a nice bead over here, kind of weld it together and retain it and save it, which is probably what I'm going to do. But anyways, I got it off, so now it's easy. So all I got to do now is basically remove the other bolt that's holding on the downpipe to the block. And you guys will find that as probably the biggest challenge of this whole installation is just because you really got to reach in there with your hands. So if you're not ambidextrous with your hands, good luck with this thing. Maybe get your friend to do it. So I got one off. I'm going to be doing the other one, and then I can remove the whole factory downpipe off. The CTS tuning pipe that I have doesn't, thank God, have a requirement to mount that because it's a lot lighter. So we should be okay. So the installation should be a breeze. Stay tuned. Oh, yeah, I also forgot to mention, if you guys are going and trying to reach for the back bolts, get yourself a pair of gloves. Gloves like these, not like the, you know, not like the regular sort of like, you know, blue gloves or whatever. Get these because as you guys are sort of reaching in the back in order to loosen up with the deep sockets, there's a lot of sort of like edgy parts from the exhaust and the shafts that are there. So well, there you go. Protect your hands at all costs, because if you're moving around, you guys are gonna have protection. So as a good tip, whenever you guys are doing the downpipe, especially when you're working behind, in order to remove the bolts, the retaining bolts to the block, wear a set of these kind of gloves to protect your hands. It'll be making it a lot easier. So if you do touch an edgy part, you guys are not gonna instantly, you know, cut yourself. So highly recommend to do that. So probably the best way to get to that stupid bolt on the opposite side of the downpipe is actually through here. Because it literally is over there, right behind where the oxygen sensor is. That's why I said it's probably a good idea to wear these suckers, because there's a lot of sort of sharp parts over here and stuff like that. Let me zoom in there, but it's literally sitting where the oxygen sensor is. So if you kind of move over here and have a deep socket, you can kind of get it from here. That's probably the best option to get to, because otherwise the downpipe is not moving anywhere. So look to the back where the oxygen sensor is. Let me turn off my light. Look to the back where the oxygen sensor is over here, and then kind of reach it from underneath the car like that, and you'll get access because it's just right above there. Hope that helps. But going from sort of around here, if you have the DSG and the automatic transmission, is a pain in the ass. So probably this is the easiest access, because you can kind of reach it where my glove is, kind of reach it through there and get to it and loosen it up. So we'll try that right now. Back view of how they look like. The two block retention screws that you bolt onto that hold the OEM downpipe. So this little pesky thing right here is what you have to struggle with, especially when you have the automatic transmission in the way. You see, guys, maybe it's a lot easier on stick, but on the DSG models, this is what I had to do. So this is just a tip. I went from this side using that mega extension, and once you guys sort of visualize that, using that extension and putting it over on that bolt and loosening it up from here and gripping it, you'll realize how easy it is to remove it. You just have to kind of play with it and visualize, and you're good. Removing the downpipe was a little bit of a struggle as well, but you gotta kind of have to push up on it as you're removing it, because it's gonna get stuck on this corner over here. So by pushing it up, you're kind of leveraging it over it, and then you're able to sort of slide it from underneath the car. Also, what helped me as well is I removed the center brace bracket over here, because then that allowed me to sort of have full
movement in order to remove the downpipe. So that's where the downpipe is. That's the factory downpipe right there. See you later, Gator. Right here. And these are the two mounts, one on this side, that's the hard one, and then one on the other side. So we're gonna transfer over this oxygen sensor. We're gonna put it in a defouler over here. We're gonna have it sort of point up this way, so that way it doesn't get in the way, and we'll install this puppy, and we're almost there. Bada bim, bada boom. A good idea as well to sort of have the defouler. I have one like that to kind of point up away, because there's a component there. But when you do bring back the downpipe and put it up, just take the oxygen sensor wires and wrap it around, so it just makes it easier to move around so they don't wiggle and get caught as you're feeding it through the pathway underneath the car. Just as a tip. All right, managed to save this little guy. Not the best welds, but they penetrated through, so we're good. Kind of tacked through. And did some on the other side as well. Pretty decent, but the most important thing is that it's strong, it's welded, it won't come anytime loose, and I'm able to reuse it, which means I don't have to go to the store and buy one, which is probably the idea behind it. So not functional, you know what I mean? That's all, you know, it's a tight space, so whatever. So we're gonna put that back, half of it. Most of it is already on. Let's have a look over here. The mid pipe's already attached to the turbo, or not the mid pipe, but the CTS downpipe. This is the clamp I needed over here that I just fixed. I'm gonna put it and I'm gonna attach it to the rest of the exhaust, and we're gonna give it a nice little startup. Oh yeah, so things are looking good. So that little sucker over there was a pain in the ass to remove on the factory one, but it's really easy to put in the CTS downpipe. There's absolutely no issues. The positioning of the oxygen sensor is a little bit of a pita as well, because I have the sort of, like, I call them the sausage ones, not the straight ones. This one's curved, so I kind of had to, you guys can see where it is, it's kind of curved behind here, and it's going up, and it's actually attaching back up to the factory harness, which is bonus. So hopefully it doesn't pull a coat. If it does, it's going to get a stage 2 tune soon anyways, so we should be okay. But for now, we just got to kind of make it work until I can get an appointment to get it tuned. Yeah, so that's that. I'm really happy that I was able to fix this clamp. Okay, so she's all mounted up. I kind of tilted the clamp a little bit so it's easier to get to. Because by default they kind of point up, which is kind of silly. So it's all bolted up to the exhaust. It's all bolted up, nice and firm. Overall, not a bad install. Just these chassis mounts, or the engine mounts to the original OEM downpipe, were a pain in the ass. So I provided you guys with a solution to it. I know there's a lot of sort of like YouTube vlogs out there where guys do it in like 20 minutes. Yeah, I guess if you're amazing and you've done it a couple of times, then you know what to look for. But realistically, this probably took me a couple hours because I struggled and I had to figure out a way to get at those bolts. Keep in mind, this is 7.5 GTI with a DSG transmission, so it's a lot bigger, I think, compared to regular transmission. I'm not sure. I've never worked on one that has a stick. But this is the way I installed mine, and it worked out great. I'm going to turn it on, and that's all. That's all she wrote. Hopefully this helps you guys out. Puppy sits nice and clean. This is where the oxygen sensor is routed, like I showed you guys. And it connects to the factory location. We're going to fire this guy up and see how she rips. All right.